that what you have for you? Is that like, you just sat down and were picking or anything like that? How was that? How did it go?
So,
yes, sir.
So.
Yes, sir. I did.
Yeah, you know, it was beautiful.
Is this your first time in Philly? Or?
Nah, not at all. It's my first time in Philly in a musical capacity.
Okay.
No, second. I shot Who Wrote Those Mad. You ever seen that video?
Okay.
I shot that in Philly.
Really?
Not the 42nd Street ball, but the rest of it is shot in Philly. Northern Philly.
Really?
The studio shot.
I would not have known that.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm saying. No, I'm welcome to the city. You got
the cheesesteak
and stuff yet?
Yeah, I ain't go though. I'm gonna go to Gino's or something. I heard Gino's a tourist spot. You gotta go to like the real hood.
I mean,
cheesesteak.
I'm hearing things. Personally, I'm hearing gyms in West Philly.
Gyms?
I'm gonna tell you now, I've never been.
What you fuck?
Cat Steaks.
Pat?
Right across the street from
Gino's.
Right across the street. All right, hands down.
Cat shit is red?
Yes.
I had them before.
Don't the glitter and the
other shit, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? How's everything going? You know, other side from the picnic, how is everything?
Everything is beautiful, man. My life is beautiful. I designed Universal Records. I got a big chunk of money and I moved out the projects.
Word.
Buy fucking Margiela shoes and hats, mixes, and all types of
living the life.
Just do what I want.
Living the life. I take it. So, you know, you just said you signed Universal. What's some things we can expect to see from that?
You're probably gonna see me on TV a lot more now. And aside from that, you know, I got another single coming out. It's coming out. You're gonna see the videos for those coming out. Some real crazy videos. And I got another mixtape coming out in August. I got another mixtape coming out in September. I got an EP coming out in September. So it's just like a lot of work. Like,
a lot of things.
You're gonna bombard niggas real quick. You take those real quick.
Work is good.
Yeah, work is always
work is
good.
Work is real good. Work equals money.
Yeah, work equals money.
Money's always good. Money is always a beautiful thing. So I mean, so in the end of the day, kids, money equals fun. That's what makes a motherfucker Esquire seller. So yeah, man, you know, you represent New York, strong. Brooklyn, if I'm not mistaken.
Brooklyn.
You know what I'm saying? Brooklyn's in the building. So you know, a lot of artists, you know, in the past, you know, 6 months to the past year, have really, you know, rose to the mainstream and the arts that we rise to the mainstream. You know, like you say, you just got signed Universal. What do you think about that? You know, just New York coming back to the mat, you know, and it seems like...
It's a beautiful thing, man. Even though, like, I don't know everybody personally, like, I don't know A$AP Rocky, I've met that like twice.
No, God.
I know Action Bronson, bro, but that's my nigga. You know what I mean? But, like, all of us is just, like, trying our best to push it forward. We got, like, New York got to a point where it was so stagnant, and the shit got corny. It got retarded almost. Like, these niggas is rapping about shit that don't even exist. Like, helicopter on top of the club, all this dumb shit. And, like, niggas ain't doing it.
They sit in the hood. Guess what the government's got.
Niggas is broke. You know what I'm saying? So, like, you need rappers to come and represent them. Like, you ain't saying, I ain't talking about no money, I ain't talking about no cars. I'm talking about that shit. That shit is just a facade. You know what I mean? So, like, you got real niggas coming up rapping, really in the world doing it. Because you know when you rap and you on, you get to a point where it's like, you get jaded to, like, what happens in society. You know what I mean? Like, you don't see it. So, like, you need young niggas to come up and still tell you what's going on in the world. Like, how you had to have Kendrick and come in LA. You had to have Austin come. Or you had to have whoever the fuck down south. Whatever the fuck. Like, you always need Meek in Philly. You know what I mean? He's a voice for the city. You know what I'm saying? And New York needs a voice. And all of us, we represent that voice. So,
okay. So, I mean, I guess being as far as an individual coming up in the New York scene, I'm glad you touched on that as far as being a voice.
Yeah.
What does your voice say?
My voice is basically saying that, like, I'm from the project. I'm from the bottom. You know what I mean? Like, where I live at, my building, it's piss on the floor, shit on the floor, it's beans in the building, drug dealers on the first floor, it's fights outside, it's gun fights down the block. And I represent all that shit, but I also represent the aspect that you don't have to be that. Come with that. You can know that shit, you can know the streets, you can be street smart, you can be educated too. You can be creative, you can be different, you can be abstract, and make your own lane. And that's what I represent, is basically saying that young black niggas that's in the projects, young black kids, they could be anything. Young black kids to the hood, they could be anything. Cause like me, I'm not the typical nigga, I never sold drugs and shit.
I'm with the college, I'm college. Hey man, where you going to school?
I went to school, I don't want to say where I went.
You went to college.
I went to college. You know, it's just like you could do shit. You know,
right.
I just try to represent another angle of that shit. Like, every rapper that come out of the hood is always, oh, I'm too cool. Like me, I come out, and I'm just like, I'm me. You know,
you like women?
My girlfriend cheated on me, and I'm broke. And you like Henny? That's my song. I like Henny.
You like Henny?
My niggas.
And that's it.
I tell a real story. There's a million niggas, like, I'm sure you're like me. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure he's like me. Everybody, like, just a regular nigga from the hood. Like, that's what I represent. It's just basically being the voice of the regular nigga from the hood. Know the shit, seen the shit, about the shit, run with the shit. He ain't the shit. He just,
just do your thing. Just be individual. I mean, you know, and I think music needs a lot more of that.
Yeah.
Just as a whole, not even whether it's from New York or swag it out, you know. You know what I'm saying? You know, not whether you're from New York, whether you're from Philly, LA, Texas, you know, it's a lot about, like you touched on before, you know, like just the next up is coming. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? Like the whole 35 and up, you know, is making the way for everybody 20 and
So,
man, I mean, you know, 2012, 2013, you know,
you say,
it's not
universal. What's up next? My EP comes September. I'm gonna have a little mixtape sprinkled through here and there. And a lot of visuals. It's gonna be a lot of visuals. And next year, y'all gonna see the album. And that basically completes what, you know, completes the plan. I can't quite tell you the plan, but I'm sure you'll see.
You can never tell a plan.
I want you to feel
it. So where can we find you on, like, social networks and stuff like that?
You can find me on Twitter, Escomania. It's eXquire. I hate spelling, but so, you know what I mean? But, that's pretty much it, man. You know what I mean? It's pretty flat and basic.
Good showing that, baby.
Thank you.
I appreciate the hospitality and everything like that. Go get that cheesesteak, like I said, Pat.
Yeah, Pat. I'm hit Pat before I go home. I swear to God.
Definitely do. All right, listen, guys. CTTV, CoreyTowns.com.
CoreyTowns.com.
Shout out to Vitamin Water.
Hide your bitches.
Stay
pussies.
Stay hydrated, my friend.
Stay hydrated with this Henny.
Stay hydrated
Henny
with
that Vitamin Water. Hey, yo, this is Mr. Motherfucking Esquire, and I'm rocking out with ICFEntertainment.com TV. You already know. You know, passionate as bitch.